I like the homing missiles. Honestly, probably the trickiest part about them is just deciding when to use them. Not getting too greedy for the actually good damage of the main gun. But I think it's reasonable. Honestly, I'm going to be able to make a lot better decisions once I'm actually familiar with the stages, but we can try and stick with homing at least for a little while. Maybe we'll switch over to one of these other ones in a future episode. We'll give this another try for now. So we call these things the four Metroid leaders, but I haven't actually seen them lead yet. I'm concerned about what will happen when we do. That's a nice little, Okay, once again, in the general philosophy of doing all these old school effects, but restrained, done properly, we have lightning flashes that are steady, gradual, not sudden and overwhelming. That's pretty cool. That is very much of the thing that the style that I prefer. Okay. But yeah, we've got the little footstep effects, we've got the little tiny, what do you even call these? Like the shimmering effect of the water on the metal surface. That's pretty neat. Like, we could have gone without that, but, oh. Hmm. So I guess you got a, lance similar to mine, is that the idea? I guess it was only a matter of time. They have all kinds of great technology at their disposal. Force fields, teleportation, whatever kind of anti-gravity flying assistive devices they have. Look, if you don't want me destroying the pipes, don't put the pipes in the way of where I need to go. It's that simple. Oh, so I guess there are just a different number of ECs per level. I guess that makes a certain amount of sense. Like, if you just give yourself the ability to do that, like, you aren't constraining yourself by needing to put the same number of ECs per level. You can actually think more about where you want to put each one, I guess. Like, secret design. Oh, that's a whole nother thing I could ramble on about for a while. And maybe I will if I have to. Okay. That was sort of the right idea. I'll figure something out. Alright, well, I guess we're playing Smash TV now. I'm just gonna pick a direction and go as far away from the entrance as I can. That usually seems to be a good policy for these kinds of things. Okay. We're gonna need to think about what to do when that happens next time. I guess just destroy it before it closes in on you. That's a perfectly reasonable strategy to take. Okay, there we go. Decently wide angle on that, too. Definitely appreciate that. Okay, so I can pick which one of these to destroy. As long as I destroy one of them, then I have enough space to deal with the other one. But I do have to deal with the other one. I'm getting hit by those drop-in guys more than I would like to admit, but it is happening. It's right there. This is part of the archival footage. This will be used to train future models. Okay, how's laser do on you? Pretty good, yeah. Definitely needed some juice there, but it destroyed it before it could even fire the main gun once, so a lot better than anything else I've tried so far. Maybe the grenades would be good against them, too. It's just hard to argue with just getting a whole bunch of energy and using it. And then refilling it, because these refills refill all of it, no matter how much you have. Okay, I see that down there. Oh, okay. So the answer was just to jump off of this platform and just walk down what was otherwise an edge tile. Okay. Sometimes it is just a simple answer. Okay, so I guess this is kind of like modest area coverage. Oh, so it's, yeah, it's passive damage. So it's, like, normally I can't shoot the main gun and the laser at the same time, but with this I could shoot, like, either the main gun or the homing, and also have this active. Hmm. And I guess it probably just uses energy as long as it's out and doing its thing. Hmm. That's, like, combinatorial explosion right there, isn't it? Like, that's just an alt, like, an enhancement to almost everything else. I think by main and alt, it means either, like, this gun or this gun. So it's not quite that bad, but it's quite a lot still. That could be pretty good. Yeah, that actually could be really good. If I'm trying to refill my laser, especially during a boss fight when it's that hard to close in on them, that could be really good. Yeah, let's give that a try. That is exactly fitting with the philosophy I just outlined earlier. Let's give that a try. Okay, the delay seems about the same as it ever was, but it is definitely reaching both wider and farther. And the charge up is... almost, but not quite full screen, and also it, travels with me while I move, too. Interesting. So I can just put that in the bank and then, unleash it. Okay, it does still have a little bit of delay then, so it's... it looks like it's about the same delay. Yeah, let's deal with you first. Now we'll come back for you. Yeah, your ability to get up there, like, half your attack can't reach me there, so it'll just kill you before you do the other half of the attack that could reach me. Makes sense. I'll take these. Eminent domain. It's all mine. Alright. Okay. You are a spider. You are contractually obligated to have a spider web attack. I understand. You don't move a whole lot, though. Like, you do one jump. But otherwise, like, you are pretty much a sitting duck for the laser. For the most part. Okay. Anything that doesn't move much is getting lasered. That is the rule. In fact, even things that do move quite a lot are still getting lasered. That is not the primary rule, but it is the secondary rule. Dang it. What might be nice for those guys is if they had a shadow that... Like one of those big exaggerated circular shadows that were above where they're gonna spawn. So I could see them coming, and then I could slow down and not get hit by them. I would appreciate that. I'm sure there's probably a reason why that's not there. Like, I'm sure I'm not the first person who has come up with this idea. I very rarely am for something straightforward like that. But, just something to think about, I suppose. Yeah, like, now I know there could be another group. So that's like another thing that you can also address with level design, was like, make the first one drop in such a way that I'm not likely to just run head first into it, and then I know to be on the lookout for something else down the line. Okay, this could be important later, but it probably isn't important now. That's the vibe I'm getting from an empty room like this. Yeah, I think we're done here. Maybe it just makes the map look nice. Not every room has to have a purpose. Okay, that I was getting ready to use the boost, but didn't actually need to do that yet. Alright, I appreciate this kind of thing being pretty readable. Like, the catwalks that you can walk on are very clearly contrasted with the other bits and bobs that are just background elements that I can't walk on. Not every game gets this right, so I appreciate this game getting it right. Yeah, see, that was good. Now they're an ambush, but they're not placed in a way where I'm likely to just run right straight hit into them. Okay, sorry. Like, again, there's no ladders in this game. I can't fly over those pipes. It's just, yeah. 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 I knew that was gonna happen. Some part of me knew that this was going to happen. Alright, something looks unfamiliar, don't know what it does, laser it. Don't even find out. Well, just picking an arbitrary direction going does seem to be working. Okay, it looks like those are just enemy spawners. In which case, lasering them is still the correct thing to do. Like, is there any case where lasering is not the right thing to do? Having a hard time thinking of one. Something that keeps dashing around and, like, stays at, like, unicorn knight's move angles to me is probably, like, the main thing that laser would be bad at. And yet, that doesn't even seem to come up that often. Probably because I guess it would be annoying to hit with your main gun, too, under those kinds of conditions. This way goes backwards. Maybe this is a good place to go? No, I'm not gonna bother. That's probably an alternate route. I've got a pretty good sense of direction. Not a perfect one by any stretch of the imagination, but good enough. I'm used to this sort of thing. Alright. We can fix that. We can fix that if I do it right. Okay, I do need to actually tap it, though. Like, I can't just press it and hold down the button a little ways. Okay. This should be a pretty good setup, as long as I get the right angle on this. There we go. That is a pretty good amount of extra laser. Okay. Without needing to worry too much about... Okay, I think that's just a static angle. It's always covering that side. Alright, fine. I know you're there. I've heard the idea that there might be a lance-only run possible in this game. I'm not gonna do that yet. Because of situations like this, where sometimes it's just correct to keep your distance. Sometimes you just need a gun to shoot something annoying from really far away. Okay, so that's what that path was about. Now I know. So we'll just skip that. We'll skip all that too, yeah. I didn't skip that super well, but I skipped it well enough. Yeah, so it's good enough to hit enemies beside me to an extent. Like, it is free. I shouldn't forget that. Like, if it kills enemies about as effectively as a laser, and I'm not in that much danger... Okay, let's try that again. Never underestimate the idea of, like, just doing the old Rogue Legacy tactics of, just deciding, nope, I don't like this room. I'm coming back, I'm doing it again. A different way. But yeah, I figured I had to get out of that hallway. I was just gonna get pincered and just surrounded in there, so I needed to get around that corner. Then I'd have cover, then I'd have more room to work with. I could keep, then I'd keep my options open. There we go. This is also a pretty good gun for these basic enemies that are trying to close in on me. Means I don't have to be nearly as precise as with the main gun. They don't have that much health. They have just enough that I need to hit them a few times. But homing does seem to clean them up pretty nicely, too. So it's good to just, like, even if I don't seem like I ever, I need a reason to swap, it can be good to just swap anyway. Then the reason becomes apparent later on. Okay, this doesn't seem like a grenade spot, though. Yeah. Laser. Oh, laser, I can always take a break from you, but I'm always going to come back to using it. Yep. There we go. It seems pretty good. Homing for a slight bit of weird angle coverage, and then... Oh. You got backup. I see. Backup from all the way up there. Yeah, it was one of you. The purple doesn't quite seem to be, like, as good of a color here. I might prefer, like, just a deep red here, but I know that color design is always a little bit tricky. And at least this is, like, consistent with how bullets have always looked like in other stages, so there is that, too. But, yeah, just, like, dark purple on, like, pale gray that's kind of purple-colored. Pale blue. Yeah, not quite as good a contrast as in some of the other stages. And maybe that's intentional to a certain extent, but, it's worth noting, I suppose. Alright, I'm taking a few scratches here and there. Still dealing with enemies pretty handily. You gonna give me any more info about that? No? Okay. Well, it probably... I don't know, it's at sea, and there's fuel involved. We've seen explosions earlier. This could be, like, an explosion-based boss. We'll just go with this for now. This should be a fine loadout. Whatever's in those crates has gotta be really good. Like, I can't blow up these crates, but I can blow up pipes. Like, imagine that. Crates that are tougher than pipes. What's the world coming to? Okay, got a big, nice, wide arena. Probably for some nice, wide attacks, I imagine. You're quick, but you go to set locations. Okay, those only home a few number of times. I'm glad I've got homing. Gonna make it a lot easier to hit this guy. I heard that this guy used to be a lot taller. I think in the dev blogs there's a note to that effect. But obviously the hitboxes would get a little bit weird. Like, it'd be tricky to figure out, like, where his hitbox was if you were standing above him, if he was really tall. So, at least this, with this shortened squat design of being roughly square-shaped like the other bosses, it's at least more clear, like, where it's safe to stand and where it's not. Where are you going? Over there. Okay. Alright, that's fine. You're just trying to scare me off. This is a show of force. But if you spread yourself out, you'll spread your bullets thinner, too. This isn't nearly as many bullets as were on screen earlier. So minimal movements will get me there. Hey, cut that out. Okay, I'm glad that was a slow charge. I appreciate that. Maybe he's going a little bit easy on me. Alright. I'm glad I have nice, reliable homing missiles that don't lose track of their targets. Yeah, let's stick with this. This is doing well. Okay. Are we gonna have another wave like that? Or is it just gonna be a series of you? The minute I feel like I want to switch weapons, every now and then, like, sometimes it just makes me, like, all of a sudden the enemy composition changes and I feel like, no, actually I do want to stick with my, original gun. So far so good. Let's try out the grenades a little bit. Actually, yeah. This is doing pretty good work. I mean, I'm out, but it was doing pretty good work while it was, in session. Oh, hey, that's some pretty good range for a shmup. Like, I can actually maybe work my way up screen if I do it just right. I don't think that actually hit, though. No, it did. I actually did get that one little bit there. So, just for reference, that's how far up I need to go in order to make that work. That said, I shouldn't, I don't actually need this right now. There we go. That's a good pattern. I like those tornado enemies. Like, they're guaranteed to get at least some amount of bullets on screen, but you can kill them with wide area weapons and stop them from flooding the entire horizontal part of the screen. So that way you have freedom to either stay in the middle or go to the right. And, like, you aren't just pressured all along the entire screen by them. Okay. Alright, I think I get that one. At least I thought I did. Okay. Thank you for backing up and giving me a little bit more room. That's very polite of you. I think this is the first humanoid one of these we've seen. Like, every other one was a machine. But this is, supposedly the more intelligent one. If, even if it, okay, yeah, see, there we go. I saw this already. I know how it works now. So now it's fair to expect me to dodge this stuff. I can press the C button if I feel trapped, but I'm not trapped yet. So far, so good. Like, I would change the missile if I felt like I needed to, but I don't need to move horizontally a whole lot for this one. In fact, I think he's actually tracking me now. Alright. Those final phases are very short, but, so far, the intensity seems to vary a little bit on them. But, it would certainly be a lot scarier if I were down at low health when that actually happened. Although, as any good shmup player does, like, I'm not paying attention to my health at all. Like, I'm just trying to dodge in the moment. Anyway. How often has it... Is this a recurring pattern that it has a name like that? I'm wondering. Is there a particular reason why it has to be just one? Well, I guess from a spacefaring perspective, it probably makes sense. Like, if you're not sure if there's ever going to be a planet out that way, then sending just one probably makes sense. Yeah, like, because if you had to send two everywhere, then you can only go to half as many places. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. Honestly, given the circumstances, that makes sense. That's not really our job, though. Maybe the follow-up team can do that. Maybe after we've destroyed all the leaders, then somebody else can do that. We don't want to spread ourselves too thin. That's their job. Okay, just three again. So do I want to save up? Or do I just want more damage? Like, I think I maybe used this, like, once. Like, I didn't even try boosting into the boss. That is something that I'll have to actually try out against the boss where I feel like... Where I feel like there's an actual, like, easy means of retreat back down to a safe area of the screen. That's something I'll have to try out. Obviously, I've been saving the thrust for safety. But using it for damage could be a form of safety in and of itself if it kills a pattern faster. Like, especially those low-health final phases. Like, maybe boosting into a boss cuts that short. Hmm. Food for thought. Well, at least if the previous level was notably to the extent that the NPCs commented on it, very few ECs, maybe the next level will have a lot more of them. So, let's just grab the damage where I can. That'll do. Then again, this looks like either the final stage or the next to final stage, so I don't know how much game we have left.